Hello everybody, welcome to tonight's live map making session. I hope everybody can hear me. If not, holler in the chat and I'll adjust my sound settings. If not, I'll just continue. I'm Ralf Schemann of Profantasy Software and I'm here tonight to show you a bit of science fiction starship mapping with drawing style from our first annual. Sue tells me I'm growling a lot. It might just be my voice is a little bit gravelly. I've had a bit of a hay fever today, so that might have affected my voice. I'm trying to avoid the growling and try to be a bit clearer if possible. If you have, as always, if you have any questions during the mapping session, just post the questions in the video chat and Sue will forward them to me as so I can answer them during the session and see that I can help you. Okay, some people coming in, which is nice. At first thought it would be quite a day with the viewers today, but it looks like people are just coming in now, which is nice. Hello everybody. So we're looking at a starship deck plan type map for tonight's map making session, and it was the first science fiction type annual issue we published with the Cartographer's Annual back in 2007, and I've just checked and I think it was actually before we came out with Cosmographer 3, and there's some stuff that were introduced with Cosmographer 3 were not even yet in this annual issue, but they were added later. But you don't need the Cosmographer add-on to use this session. It all works on its own. If you have the Cosmographer add-on, then you can easily use the symbols and stuff from that add-on in this style, but otherwise you can just should be able to follow along just fine. So let's see what we're gonna do. We're gonna start out by creating a new map, and I'm going up to the file toolbar here where all our add-on buttons are and click the new map icon, and here we've got the map type Cosmographer, where all our science fiction drawing styles are collected under. So we're going to use this and keep the desired settings myself, option, and click next. And you'll find this style in three different templates, actually, in the Annual Starship Large, Annual Starship Medium, and Small selections, and that's because we included a few things in this or had a setup at the time which didn't scale too well with very large differences in maps. So we set up three different templates where you could scale up and down a little bit from and get the best effects. Nowadays this would not be necessary anymore because the sheet effects now can scale to the map size better. But it's a bit of a legacy that we've got the three different versions up here in the map style list. They all use the metric system, though. For science fiction maps, we tend to go with metric only. So for this session, I'm going to choose the small ship because starships can get very large and very hard to fill with detail and everything, and we only have a short time to create our map, so we'll do a small one and choose the small template. Click next, and here I'm setting the size of my ship, and I'm doing a fairly small one for say 40 by 30 meters, still not a small vehicle. I'm not going to put in a map title at this point, I'll do that later. I'll just click finish and save the map. And here's our new map coming up, and you'll see, well, one of the reasons we've got these different templates is the key in here, because that's easier to, if you have not too much scale difference in a map. And one thing you'll also notice, this map doesn't have the sheet effects on when it is created. That's why you're seeing these fairly obvious colored polygons in the background. I'll just show you how this is supposed to look when we turn on the sheet effects. And click the sheet and effects indicator up on top to bring up the drawing sheet effects dialog, and I activate sheet effects, click OK. And here's our nice, soft, nebula-like star field, which is in the background. This is all actually created with vector style objects. There's no bitmap textures used in this drawing style. So you don't need any external resources when you're sharing these kinds of maps. And if you want to turn and keep on sheet effects working, this style is perfectly suited for that. And you can, if you want to also always open the map to open with the sheet effects on, I'll just quickly show you how to change that setting. So for that, you click the display speed settings on the left toolbar. And here we do have the option effects are on when loaded. And this will, the setting will be saved with the map. And each time now you open the map from the Windows Explorer or within Campaign Cartographer, it will have the sheet effects activated when it starts. And we're just going to save the map. If you wanted to change that on the template, you could do the same by opening the template file, changing the setting in there, and then saving that. And then every time you start a new map based on that setting, on that template, it would start with the sheet effects activated. Good. So let's have a look. We've got our blank map. We have a color key here for certain types of areas of the ship. We'll get back to that, how to use that later. And we just want our ship outline first. And the style originally did not come with the mirrored polygon drawing tools. That's because that was a cosmographer feature. And but we've added some of these in the meantime, and I'll also show you how you can create your own. So to start our whole outline, we'll just click the All Drawing Tools button. I'm not going to switch to the cosmographer menu here, because I want to show you how to use this even if you don't have Cosmographer installed, and you won't have that menu if you don't own Cosmographer. So we'll just stick with the default floor plan drawing tools menu interface we have here. So let's scroll down, and we've got some hole stuff here. So I can see we've got a hole surface and a default one where you can change the color in here, and but I'm going to just use the standard mirrored surface drawing tool. The mirrored tools are always very useful for starships, because they tend to be symmetric, but you can of course just use the standard tool to create any irregular shapes. Okay, so just a quick showing you something, because the drawing tool is set to align its fill style, which is used in with the first line we draw. So if you start out our starship with a diagonal line and then just quickly finish it. Yes, it's not very obviously. Let me just take a look again. Here in the mirrored lines, mirrored outline, align to first edge option is here. I am, and if I redraw that a little more diagonal here, you can see it better, that the fill style does align with the first line I'm drawing. It wasn't quite that obvious because I used a 45 angle line as my first line. You'd see that this is a bit offset from the horizontal line, which might be something you want, but sometimes it can be a bit strange looking on a symmetric shape like a starship hull. So if you do not want that, make sure your first line is straight, or as I've just shown you, disable the setting. So we're going to do this now. So again, I'm going to go to the All Drawing Tools, Advanced button, select my tool I'm using, and the fill for the tool is the outline, actually, because it's an extra entity drawn on top. And there on the properties, I'm going to use fixed angle and make it angle 0, so it's always aligned to the horizontal. Just a little extra information. This fill style is realized as a hatch style, meaning it's a repeating vector fill. And this creates a lot of different entities in the map because every line and shape in the hatch style is drawn as its own entity. So this can get a bit overwhelming on very large maps. If you have a very large starship, and then I would recommend to not use such a hatch fill style. But here for our small ship, that will be no problem, and we'll go ahead with that. So finally, let's get to actually drawing our hull. And I'm gonna turn on my grid so I have a nice visual representation where I put my points. Start with the nose of the starship here on the left, and then I want to draw some kind of wings, so it's also an atmospheric capable ship. It can enter a planetary atmosphere. Then add a rear section for the engines. Extra. And then when I'm done, I can just right click to finish my ship outline. And here we are. A redraw to show the sheet effects. And we do have a little. Sometimes the hatch style, especially on sharp corners like this one here, can get a little bit messy. Let's turn on sheet effect, turn off sheet effects, so we can see this. See, it did create this intersection here. But what we can usually do is just unlock groups, because hatch fills are grouped entities. And erase a node, no, or erase one of the polygons here. See, you can just erase this little polygon, and then we've got that cleaned up. Turn on sheet effects again. Lock the groups again, and we are good to continue drawing the map. Good. So we've got our hull outline here, and then as we want to draw an interior deck, we do need the actual floors, called decks in our sci-fi maps. So this is going to be the next thing we are drawing. So I'm going to right-click the drawing tool button again, and we do have a number of different hatch styles for our floors in here. See the rivets, and the rivets already has the mirrored version, but the others don't, and that's because I created the mirrored version for the floor rivets, the riveted floor, earlier when I was trying out the style, and I want to show you how to do that for the other ones. So let's say I want the tiles here to use as a mirrored drawing tool, floor tiles. I'll just do a new I first select the matching drawing tool, then click new, because that will create a copy of the existing one that I've previously selected. Just append mirrored to the name, or you could rename it anything you wanted, but this is how I've been handling these. And then I'm gonna choose a different draw method and just choose the mirrored polygon. And that's all I need to do. And I've got my floor tiles here. I would actually think I might want the small version mirrored as well. So I'm going to do the same here, because for our small ships, perhaps the mirrored tiles, the small tiles are a better option. Again, choose the draw method, mirrored polygon. Save the settings. And now I'm gonna draw the floor of our starship. This is gonna be our cockpit up here, and then we have a main section. You see, we're starting from the same center line as the original ones. The mirrored drawing tool version will make sure that I'm doing a nice symmetric floor plan that matches the whole outline. I just have to make sure that I'm starting on the same center line as the hull. Here we go. And I'm actually gonna stop at this point, because see, that's our floor plan. I want to change the texture for our engineering section. So I've drawn our crew quarters and cockpit area here to start with, and now I want to add an engineering section. And for that, I want to do the lattice hatch style. Again, I'm gonna create a mirrored version. I can also just say I wanted to, let's do a little bit of irregularity here in this rear section. So just to show you, so I'm just gonna use the polygonal version instead. And I can just click here, say I wanted to, a certain section here be in a different style. I just have to be careful that I get this right. And you can already see that this is a bit problematic here with the hatch style, because it's a bit too large for the size. So let's redo this with the small version, and see I'm hitting quite a few different entities here. That's because the hatch styles overlap, but I can always say I don't want these sections here, and this way I'll just remove the area here at the back. So let's have a look. That's the small lattice version. And let's draw this again. Let's do the missing section here at the bottom this time. And again, I'm running into this problem with the lines crossing this here, because it can't handle the insert, basically. But we'll just leave it at this and say this is a feature of our floor plan. And what I'm going to do, I'm going to use the rivets for the part that I'm leaving out. Here we go. And I'm covering up the lines of the hatch style below. That's simply because both the hatch style and the fill behind it go on the same layer, on the same sheet, and so I can just draw on top of it and cover those lines up. Good. So there's my floor. I could add a little bit more in the wings, saying perhaps this is fuel area where fuel is stored. So let's do that and show you how to make use of the mirror shape without actually using the mirrored drawing tool version. So let's use the rivets again and just draw a section of such a floor plan here at the side. And now I'm going to say I want a mirrored copy of the prior entities I've just drawn. See, they get selected, D for do it. And now I just need to draw a mirror line. And for that, I'm going to draw a line just on our center line for the whole shape. And then we do have this on the other side there. And what I didn't do first, I didn't change my current drawing sheet to the decks. That's why this ended up on the hull and not on the decks. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to use move to sheet, again select by prior, do it, and put this on the deck sheet. And now you'll see that the sheet effects get properly applied to that section of the floor as well. So we've got our floor outline, and next up we do need our bulkheads. I like to, of course, you could just add interior stuff to this, but I'm going to show the actual bulkheads, the area of the ship protecting the crew and passengers from the void of space. I want to place that around the deck plan. And for that, we do have our drawing tools up here. And let's have a look. We do have different widths. We can also set our own width, but let's try half meter bulkhead line. And we don't have a closed version of that in here, so I'm just gonna quickly create a closed version because I want to go all around our existing shape. So I'm going to do closed and just choose the closed option. Okay. And now I'm going to follow my outline here. I should also be able to use trace. But only on the one entity. I would have to change between different entities for the tracing, so it might be just easier because I still have the grid enabled to just use the grid points to draw my hole, which I'm doing now. And right click to finish. And there's my hole, my bulkhead, and for small map, I realized this is actually still a bit too thick. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to use change properties, where I choose line and width, I select by prior again. Okay, it's been an autosave in the meantime, which means I can't use prior. So what I'm going to do is I'm just going to choose by layer and choose the bulkhead layer. And there's our layer selected. Press D for do it. And say half of that would probably be fine, so 0.25 meters, refresh screen, and that looks good. So this is my hull outline, bulkheads. Okay, I've got a question from Vivan. I haven't used hatch styles very much. Is this a common problem with them? Yes, it's a bit, if you use hatch style, it's better to use a few more basic shapes and not too complicated ones, because especially if you've got indentations in your polygons, then sometimes the tool gets problems filling that up and connects entities that cross the the indentations you have in your drawing. So it's better to draw several shapes in more basic forms and use hatch styles on those. Okay, those are my outer bulkheads. Let's put in some interior walls. Bulkheads, we've got, should have some walls somewhere, I thought. Yeah, there we are, interior wall. And let's set a current width of 0.15. Don't need to be quite as wide as the exterior ones. I think they have a default width of 0.25 as well, so just using the same width, this is just fine. There we are. Let's have a quick look on our drawing tool. These are all fairly old and I might have done some changes in the meantime while working on these. So the interior wall does have fixed width. So what I actually would like to do is use the current width for those. So I'm just changing this option here. Save the tool. And now I should be able to use the current width I'm setting. Just putting in some extra walls here. And perhaps something in here. And there's the interior walls for our ship. So next up would be filling up our little spaceship with some interior stuff and doors and things like that. Good, so let's have a look. We do have different doors here. There's fairly simple vector symbols that come with the style and just a small selection. It's an annual style after all and not a full add-on. Again, you can just use the Cosmographer symbols with these as well, but I'll gonna stick to the symbol versions here because I also think they make for a very nice and abstract little deck plan style. See, if I wanted to add a sliding door here to our entrance to our bridge, I can. What I should do now is to actually, because see, it's an aligning symbol. See, it changes direction as I move it around, but it aligns to all kinds of entities behind the cursor. And we do have a lot of entities here, all the different hatch styles, and the symbol doesn't know what to align to. Or actually, it does know exactly what it's aligning to, but I can't hit the one I need to. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to turn off some sheets that have all the details on. See the, not the sheets, but the layers. See, we've got the textures layers here, and if I hide those, then all the texture entities will be hidden and not interfere with our map making. Same I can do with the holes, with the sheets, with the background, nebula and stars, so they don't get in the way. And so our map does look a lot simpler now, but it's much easier to work with. So again, let's actually change to a proper layer here, to the bulkhead layer, click our sliding door again, and you can see now the symbol now aligns correctly to our wall. And it also breaks a nice little gap into the wall, indicating they're opening. And we're good to go. Now I want to show the different areas in different colors to indicate the function and use the symbols in that color as the one here. So you can see we already have some different colored sections here, but not everything. So if I wanted to draw a crew, then I would need to use the varicolor version here. And for that, to see that, I can use an info list on the crew color here. And it's actually the second color on this symbol. It's the 150 should be the color for the crew. See, if you have a look, it's the 150 here. That's the orange that matches to the crew. If I take a look at the bridge, then see, it's the color 166. If I set my current color, oops, that was the line width, color to 166, you get the same red in here as the bridge indicator. And I'm not gonna change my layer to furnishings and go to the bridge here, pick up my chair and the color I've chosen, perhaps turn off sheet effects, align my chair. Actually, I wanted to use the default size. So let's put in a couple pilot seats in here and use the arrow key to align it in the cardinal directions. Add another seat here and one down here. And there we have the seats in the crew color. And what you can also do, you can see you've got some areas for stuff like wall fixtures and machinery and stuff in the different colors. So we can choose the bridge area color here and that, and you get these nice furniture or furnishing looking areas. And if I turn on the snap, I can also make sure, actually the grid is a bit too large for this at the moment here, so let's what we can do, we can add more snap points to our grid. So I'm just going to edit my 1 meter one snap grid, name it 1 meter four snap, add four snap divisions, click OK. And now I do have a little bit more control here over my points. And add another section here at the front. It's all nicely behind the bulkheads. And that way I've set up my bridge area here. So then next up, this might be the crew area. And then actually we probably need some staterooms at the edges. So let's add interior wall again. At our smaller size, let's create a few rooms here at the side. At the sides, they will be pretty small, but a crew on a starship wouldn't have much space usually. So now I want to switch to my crew color. And that was, I just remember, it was the 150. I could check on my crew entity of course, or just draw in a furniture shape and check on that. change to furnishings or stay on the furnishings. And then we've got some beds here. And we probably also need some doors. And if you wanted to not a door, but just a simple gap in the wall or something, we could also just break the wall. But I'll leave it at this. Just putting a couple more doors here. It's really very small that I've done here. It's a tiny ship, so we don't have much space in there. So let's add a couple more doors here. Here, one here, on these being larger areas, we might probably already have some crew members sharing these. There we go, and here, at a table. Some chairs around that for a lounge. And then we've got to add some crew colored crew area furnishings here. Oops, that was a bit off. There we go. And there's storage areas. Lockers, a kitchen. No need to show all this in detail, just outline some general fixtures on the walls. There we go. And we do need a few more doors. We do need one leading to this area and to this. Oh, actually, I forgot that we do need some kind of entrance into the engineering section here in the lateral corridor we have here. So what we do need to edit our fixture here on the wall. So I'm just going to select the same deck crew area again. I'm going to edit the existing entity. And oh, we've got some. Let's just remove some notes here. And we might not need to have everything exactly in aligned. So we just put the entrance in here. And put in another door here. Oh, okay, I think I broke the wrong entity here with the door. Instead of we've got a section of that entity actually running down here, which the door hit when it broke something behind it. So we'll just remove that. And we're gonna go for the central line again, now that we've done here. And here again, see what's happening here. The symbol should actually be set to see the sliding door here to only break entities on the bulkhead layer, so it only breaks walls. But it's set a little bit differently. So what we're gonna do, we're gonna edit this, choose good question. So let's have a quick look here. Can we select just the control line, control point? What we can do, we can send the control point to the back Well, it's color, it should be color 2, yeah. And then we can use the numeric edict, because it will be the first one to... Ah, no, sorry about that. I was actually doing, had something wrong in mind. The symbol setting I was wanting to change is not saved with the control point, so I can just safely not save this, what I've done, just forget what I've been trying to do here. So instead, I'm going to go to the symbol manager, click the sliding door, and click the options, and say control points only could cut on the same layer. But then I do need to make sure that my control point list by color 2 is actually on the bulkheads layer. List by color 2, do it, and it is on the symbol definition layer, which I thought it would be. So what we're going to do is we're going to use change layer prior, we're going to change the layer of our control point, and that's going to be bulkhead. And now, if you use the sliding door, it should only break the bulkhead and not the floor outline below it. Oh, worked after all. This was a little excursion into symbol editing and fixing some old symbols that were set up differently back then. Get. We've got that, and need an entrance into this room. Actually, make it two entrances here. Then for the... No, these shouldn't have entrances, because they this will be in the fuel areas. What we would have is... These might be the access points where people can enter and leave the starship. So what we're going to do, we put a valve door into these. And this will probably also now break the floor background, because we are clicking on the edge of the floor here behind it. Let's have a look. Yes, see, that's what's happening. The symbol encounters the floor outline when I click it and breaks that instead of the bulkhead. So... let's undo this and show you a different way to just circumvent that for the time being, because we can just hide the deck. And we'll hide the... Oh, that's the doorbell ringing here, so but not now. Okay, and... I need to change the size of my symbol a little bit, so I want to make that not exceed the edges. Okay, so sorry, I'll be right back in a moment. Okay, I'm back. That was the pizza service trying to deliver when I did not have any pizza ordered. Very strange. Okay. Back to mapping here. And the cat is coming along. Hi, Aza. How are you doing? You've been woken up by the doorbell, I guess. Come on, I need to leave my view to the screen, otherwise I can't work. Come on here, you can go on my lap. There you go. No, no time for the lap. Okay, good. So we were working on the valve doors for the entrance. Yeah, the size. This seems to be a good size for our airlock doors. Here we go. And they broke the walls correctly. It looks good. Okay, so we've got the doors all entered. Let's go in and have a look at adding some engineering stuff at the back. So let's see. What do we have here? Yeah, we've got the engine area. And for that, I like to put some complicated machinery in the center. Draw some irregular shapes here. Of course, you can always go in back later and change that if you don't like what you've done. Here we go. And what I can also do, I can put some actual engines in here, so something that extends beyond our engine room. And I want to make that symmetrical, because otherwise thrust will be badly messed up. So what I'm gonna do, I'm just gonna use a mirrored copy again. Do it and mirror along our center line. There we go. And again, I do need to change because mirrored copies is not a drawing tool and will you just use the current sheet I'm working on instead of the proper drawing tool sheet. I'm going to use move the sheet on this engine and put it on the engineering sheet. Oh, that's actually not the sheet these are on. So let's have a look. Where do we have this? This is on the functions sheet. Okay, so what I'm going to do is going to move to sheet. Do it. Functions. That's better. So our then we do have our specific set aside area, which might house something that special there, either the computer or the jump drive or something else entirely, whatever fits your science fiction setting. There we go. And what else do we have in colors? Do we need something else to set up here? Passenger area. Our ship is too small for passengers. We don't have any passengers. So we're good with that. What we could do is just indicate that this is actually the fuel storage. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to use the deck area varicolor and use something like a purple and then just fill this area up with that color. We go. And show all again, as well as showing all the layers. And there's our ship layout. Let's have a look. What do we have? Some kind of engine glow, which I always like to add to my maps. In here? No, it's not in this drawing style, but I can perhaps show you in a moment or to set up something like that yourself. What we also need is some labeling, of course. So we could just go for our text areas here, not hit the stars, but the text. and then add stuff like the title and labels for the ship. So let's say this would be the power plant. This would be the engine or the drive. Let's call it the drive. And this is the jump drive. Two lines, so it does fit our area better here. Let's add the fuel designator to these wing areas. And bridge, mess hall, and so on. You can see where this is going, how we are adding all labels here. Then we do need our ship name, so this is probably a scout ship or something. Scout class. No, class is usually named after the first ship of its type. So let's say this is the Falcon class. Scout ship. Make the title text larger, of course. And let's add for crew, add a few designators here, atmosphere, capable, perhaps a size indicator, 120 ton ship, smaller. This below the title. Okay, I see we are deep into tribble discussions, always very good for science fiction. So, I wanted to show you how to make the background a little bit more interesting, add a little bit of extra to the background with the add of an engine glow. So we'll put that at the back, and we can just add a new sheet, call that background engines. Let's just copy the effects from the nebula, because they're already a nice blur and transparency. Paste these, but perhaps make the blur a little less strong. So make it 4 units, and also the transparency a little bit less. So, or a little bit more actually. So 60% opacity. And then we just gonna add our own layer for this as well. Let's call it engine glow. So we just have this neatly organized, and then we've got gonna choose a color, say a bright blue, and then I'm just gonna draw my engine glow here at the back. Turn off the grid. A few jagged lines. Go to refresh. Let's have a look. Oh, it's actually vanishing quite a bit, so let's see whether we can decrease the blur further. Move this a bit, do an apply. Oh, that's looking better. Now we can actually seal a bit of the glow. Good, and that's how you can use the Starship style from the August issue of the Cartographer's Annual 2007. Of course, you can create a much larger ships with that as well. For that, I would recommend to turn off the hatch styles for the fills. I use the non-hatch style drawing tools for the hull and so on. So you don't get that many entities, but the fairly simple colorized interiors and stuff make for very easy to draw large scale ships, actually. You can just show the different kinds of areas in different colors. So I hope you liked our tonight's little session and our work for a little scout starship. And shown you a little bit of drawing tool editing and editing symbols along the way. And next week it's probably going to be Remy doing something for you. See, he's already come up with a pretty good topic, I think, and I hope you will like it next week. Apart from that, hope you enjoy your map making, even in the summer, if the weather perhaps doesn't let you get outside, or it's too hot. And enjoy your map making, and see you again soon. Have a nice evening, or day, or whatever it is on your side of the world. Bye-bye.